Yes. So what we are going to discuss here means, okay, we are going to discuss about that, what is the, okay, what are the different seaborne plotting functions that we are having in that, how to visualize the statistical relationships. Statistical relationships means here we are going to work on a variable, single variable or multiple variables, right? On a single variable that we are going to work on the entire data, but whenever we are going to work on the multiple, okay, multiple variables, there we are going to find the relationship between the one variable to another variable. What is the correlation between the one variable to another variable? These type of statisticals that we are going to represent by using these functions, which belongs to the seaborne. Right? So in this visualizing statistical relationships that we are going to discuss about, okay, scatter plots. So all these scatter plots already that we discussed in the matplot, some little bit in depth, okay, in the form of statistical analysis, that we are going to visualize this. So how to, okay, work with the line plots, like we are having some of the facets. So how to work on this, and also, okay, we are going to discuss that how to work on the categorical data, that is plotting with the categorical data. So categorical data is also very important. Why? Because just now that we observed that, okay, some of the data sets like a TIPS or a IRIS data set. Whenever if you observe the IRIS data set, in that it is having the five variables. In that five variables, first to four variables are the, okay, petal length, petal width, sepal length, and sepal width. So the values of these variables, it is a numerical, okay, it's a totally independent values. Okay, totally independent values. Whenever if you observe the species of this IRIS data set, there you can observe that here it is having the categorical data. Why? Because whatever the flowers like a setoso, versicolor, virginica, these three flowers are repeated. These three flowers are, okay, frequently repeated up to 150 flowers throughout the data set. So this type of data that we can consider as a categorical data. So in this categorical data also that we can do the lot of analysis. So why? Because already that we worked on the used cars, right? Already that we worked on the user cars, okay, that how many SC cars are there, how many SCL cars are there, how many SCS cars are there, okay, and also we visualized the data, okay, based on this categorical data in the R programming, right? Same similarly here also that we can do that, okay, that we are, whatever the scatter plots that we observed here on a particular variable, that we are going to work on the categorical data, categorical scatter plots, right? And also that we observe this, how this categorical data is distributed, how the categorical data is distributed. So distribution is also very important. See, I will show you the data set once observe this. Right. So let us observe this data set, IRIS data set. So this is the IRIS data set that we are having. Okay, this is the species. In this total, it is having 150 observations. Once if you observe the data here, okay, first 50 are the setoso. First 50 are the setoso. Next 50 are the versicolor. And last 50 are the virginica. So the data is distributed like this. Whenever if you observe the categorical, in this categorical, the data is distributed. First 50 observations are about the setoso. Second 50 observations is about some versicolor. Next it is about virginica. So the data is, okay, 50-50-50. It is like that, right? So here it is very important how the data is distributed. Why? Because whenever we are giving this data to the system for doing the analysis, okay, first, okay, it is going to start learning about this observation. There it will find that the target, it is the setoso based on all these different values. After learning all these values, and then it will find that the species, it is the setoso. So continuously it is going to learn like this, okay, based on these values it will learn. Then the system will mainly concentrate on the setoso only, right? And then after learning some, okay, observations, and then if you try to evaluate with these values, the system will not answer, okay, for the whether it is a versicolor or setoso, right? So why? Because the data distribution is very important on the categorical okay, how the data is distributed, whether it is in the randomized or whether it is in the group wise, so that it is very important. So these are all the things that we have to do in this visualization. These are all the, okay, by using this visualization that we are going to observe that how the data it is distributed, right? And also we are going to use some of the statistics, okay, on the categorical. So statistics is not only on the numerical data that we can apply on the categorical also, but it is not possible on the statistic on the string data types, but it is possible on the numerical data types, and also it is possible on the categorical data types, right? So actually we have to discuss something about the categorical data type. Okay, so categorical data means the similar group of data that we are going to consider as a categorical data, but how it is going to stored in the systems, in the data frames, is very important. Why? Because just now that we loaded the data, whenever if you loaded the data, at the time it is considered some of the data sets are the categorical data, some of the variables that it is considered as a categorical data, right? How it is considered as a categorical data means wherever the values that it is frequently repeated throughout the data set, then it is going to consider that it is a categorical data. And again, it is having some history that internally it is stored with the numerical values. Okay, but it is going to returns with the label. So all these things that we discussed in the, where we discussed in the R programming, there it is the data type, it is a factor, but here it is a categorical. That is the difference. And the remaining everything, it is common. Yes. So here we are going to work on the relationships and we are going to work on the wide format. So and so in this plotting the categorical data. And also we are going to observe that how the data it is going to distribute it. All right. And also we are going to find some of the linear relationship and we are going to work on the multi-plotting. Same how we plotted multiple plots in the matplot. Here also we are going to work on the multi-plottings. Otherwise the extra things, the low-level plottings that if you want to do, for example, if you want to add the styles or if you want to add the colors and so, right? So all these things that we can do under the low-level plotting. Under the low-level plotting. So these are all the things that we are going to discuss here. So now let us start the how to visualize the statistical relationships. So if you want to work with the statistical relationship, in this seaborn, we are having so many functions. In this seaborn, we are having so many functions. In that mostly that we are going to use for the plot, that function is called, okay, REL plot. This is the function that we are going to use. By using this, that we are going to work on different plots. Like for example, if you want to work on the scatter plots, this is the function that we are going to use. If you want to work on the line plots, this is the plot that we are going to use, right? Particularly if you want to use the scatter plot, then we are going to use a function that is called scatter plot is the function that we are having. This is the function. Particularly that if you want to work on the line plot is the function that we are having. So instead of, okay, working these different plots, they, okay, in this real plot that we are having, one of the argument, that argument is called kind is the argument. What is that argument? Kind is the argument that we are having. By using this kind argument that we are going to work on the scatter plot or line plot or so and some other plot. Why? Because here we have to specify that what type of plot that you require here, what kind of plot that you require. Okay, instead of working on the scatter plots, that you can work on the REL plot. Here you have to specify that kind equals to scatter. Kind equal to scatter. So here it is going to plot the scatter plot. The same thing that if you want to, okay, plot in the line. So simply we have to mention that kind equals to line. Right? So like this, that we are having some of the functions. Okay, based on these functions that we are going to work. And one of what is the main advantage means here, whatever the plots that we are having, all these plots are well graphically, okay, developed. So it at the time of visualization, okay, it is better than the plots that what we observe in the matplot plots. All right. So right. So after importing that, then we have to start the plottings. Just it will take one to one session it is to complete this seaborn. How to work on all these, the categorical data or the numerical data or a simple variable or a relation so and so, right?
Just a minute. Right. So we are having some of the functions in this seaborn library, okay, by using those functions that you can plot that however that you require. So whatever the function that we observed just now, that it is REL plot, by using this REL plot that you can visualize the scatter plots or line plots that however that you require. But the main thing that we have to focus on, what are the arguments it is having. Based on that arguments only that we are going to visualize, based on that arguments only that we are going to separate the data in a different colors and so and so, right? So REL plot is one of the function. Like similarly that we are having so many functions if you want to fit the screen, and kind is also very important. Okay, on which, what kind of plot that you want to represent, that kind is also important, right? Mainly we are going to use 3 or 4 important plottings, okay, plot functions in this seaborn. Yes, that we will continue the session tomorrow. Tomorrow maximum that we are going to complete this seaborn. So it takes only one, it required only one more session to complete this seaborn. Okay, here we are having some of the functions like just now that we discussed REL plot is one thing, and categorical cat plot is one thing, point plot is one thing, like nearly 3 or 4 plots functions that we are having. No need to use a separate functions like a scatter plot, line plot, box plot, so and so. Everything that we are going to work here itself by changing the argument names, that what kind of plot that you require. So tomorrow that maximum that we will try to complete, and then we will start with the machine learning. Yes, right. Thank you. Thank you.